Welcome to this MedTool video tutorial. In this tutorial, I show you how to convert image data, set up a new project, crop a region of interest, and save the project. Medical images usually come with different formats. Well known is the DICOM format, which has lots of information in it. On the other hand, we have the RAW format, which only keeps the data. In MedTool, we use something in between, the so-called MHD or NRRT format. I prepared already an example folder with DICOM images in it. First, let's create a new project folder, which I called My Projects. Next, we're opening MedTool and we set this project folder as our working directory. So simply choose this folder as working directory. Now we can go to the directory manager. If we click to work, we directly come to our working directory. We see we have one folder project and one folder DICOM images. The next step, we'd like to convert the DICOM images into the My Projects. What we can do now in this working directory, we can automatically create a folder structure. By clicking this button here, we can automatically generate this project folder structure. In our case, we only will have scan data, we will edit our images, and we will also write out a MedTool database file. If I'm clicking OK, what I have now, I have under my project, I have these three folder structures. Next, what we will do, we will copy our DICOM data into this scan folder. And I will rename it and give it the name 00 DICOM data. I will talk about the number later. So we have our data already here. Next, we'd like to convert the DICOM data to MHD format. Therefore, we're using the image processor script, and I give this script the name. Underline, this is important because underneath is an XML database, 01. I call the script convert, and I also keep the MIC, which means medical image converter, in the name to know which script was modifying the data. By clicking OK, the script is here created. I'm also creating a folder here, which I give the same name, which is called here 01. Convert MIC. The underline is not necessary in this case, and I have a new folder here. Now I'm ready to read here the DICOM data, and because I set already my path to the working directory, I'm directly jump into here. I can select a DICOM file. If you'd like to know what this option is doing, simply click here on the help and you get the short help here. And in case of DICOM files, as you can see here, it tells you that you can select an arbitrary DICOM file and the reader detects all other files automatically. One more thing, we have here the full path. This full path is not necessary because this part of the path is the path to the projects. We can delete it because we already have the path here in the working directory, which is automatically appended to this file. So let's first read this and see what happened. So we're reading now the data. What we see here, first information, the model info. We see that the file has this size. We have also here voxel length and image formats in the file. Next, we'd like to convert this file here into our format. So we can simply select here under RScan. We will convert or write the files here into this directory. I give the file also the name image, which has the advantage if I have several data sets, I can have in each of these folder structures the same name of the image in it. I also deleted here the first part of the path. Next, we have to think about the raw format, which we write out. So what we saw here, if we simply convert this, it's now reading the DICOM data. We already converted the data. We write out the MHD file. We also see in the folder now two files, the MHD, which is a header file, and the raw file. We can read the MHD file, the header file here with the reader. Don't select the raw, select the MHD format, and we see what's inside this file. And we detect also that the format is float. But we only would need int 16, which only keeps 2 bytes of memory per data point. Therefore, I select here as raw output format int 16. I again run it and reload this file. And now we see we have another file format. Nothing has changed. If you'd like to see what's inside the file, we have several possibilities. The first one I would do, I simply copy this path and I create so-called midplanes. These midplanes here, if I'm selecting this option, I will run MedTool and you will see what happens. It's writing out midplanes on the one hand side here, and it's also giving me here more images. I can view these midplanes by the image viewer. You can select one of these, it doesn't matter, and you get here a midplane. So you see there is a bone in it and also a phantom. You can change here the contrast. You can also get here more the same information of the image again. If you pick, you see you can get here the gray value. You could also measure a length. So if you'd like to measure the diameter of the femur, you see here the length, and this gives you a first impression. But of course, it's not clear what else is inside this bone, inside this image. So the second possibility is we also write out a projected image. We can give the same file format. Why? Because also, like in the midplane, after writing out the midplane, we see here that MedTool automatically appends here the ending XM, YM, and ZM. And the same thing is for the projected images. So if we let this run, we see that the projected images are also written. And if we open now the same folder, we see images which has the ending P for projected. If we open the images, we get a different view. It looks like X-rays. Again, changing the contrast, we see here nicely that there are two femurs and the phantom is inside this data set. So now next, I'd like to take this and crop out a piece of the bone. So, but first to do so, we now would generate a next image processor script, and I would call it here convert, but we have here different folders. So first I would go here under extras and create an info text, and the first info text keeps the folder name. I call it a scan, and I move this up. So you see here you can move this up, and I also create a second one which is called bEdit. So I have an info text. If I, for example, click too fast and I did not insert anything, I can simply here either by the right click rename, or here by rename this, and I rename this by bEdit. So we already detect what this means. The same thing is also here. We can simply move here the scripts here, cut the scripts and so on. And now under this folder bEdit, we'd like to create a new image processor script, which again is the first script into this folder. This script is we call it crop, and it's a mix script. I click OK. So also one trick, if you already say Control C here, you click OK, you're creating now the new script, and then I'm creating here a new folder, Control V, and I have now a new folder in it. Now we have to link the output from here. The output from here is this MHD file, and we give this MHD file as input here. So if you let this run, we see the same file is read and it's nothing is done else. So what we can now do, we can write out the information. Therefore, I'm selecting the folder. I give the file name again, only image.mhd. It has the same name. I don't have to append any endings because I have my folder structure already here. And I'm also deleting here this absolute path. The advantage is when you move then your project to another path, everything is working without the need of a modification. So always, if you have small files, try out if everything works fine. Yes, we have now the images converted. We can also output now, for example, the midplanes. I would also change the format here. You can output the midplanes. Therefore, as you saw before, I simply do this, call this BNG. We can also output the projected images. In our case, we will only need the projected CAM images. So if you let this run, and we're looking into the viewer, we will get, of course, the same result because we did not modify anything. So we have the same images. And now we'd like to crop the images. And for example, if you'd like to have this bone, how can this be done? There is a nice feature here. If you click here on raw selection, what you can do here, you simply roughly click here around the femur, around this part you'd like to select, and then you click on this button here. So you see the bounding box is automatically selected. Here we see that the bone is still too big. So what you can do, you click on this part here again, roughly the bounding box, and again click this button so the old ROI is recognized and we see here the ROI. In case you'd like to change the thing, you can of course also modify the stuff here, but this clicking is much more comfortable. So now how can this information be used here in the script? We simply copy this line, which is the bounding box, Control C. And if you're looking into this script, we have here the command panel, and we have here something which is called resize. If you click on resize, we have the possibility to crop a region of interest, and these numbers directly fit into this format. So if you let this run, and looking at the output, now MedTool automatically also overrides this file and also automatically updated the view. So that's the reason why we have this view here. We can change the contrast and we see nicely the cropped bone. In case you are, for example, you have this ROI deleted and you let this run, you have the old image. So what you simply can do, you can take this ROI, you select it, you copy the ROI into this field, and you again see the same region of interest. Now finally, what we'd like to do, so quickly check this thing here. So we see the new images, and also here we have the same folder with the same image name cropped. So finally, what we'd like to do, we'd like to save our database. So therefore, we simply click here on save. Of course, also the save is here. So we see this file option here allows us to save the things. And now we see why we need here this in this project folder, this set med tool. So I would save this here under the same name. I call it my project. The format is XML. So if you save it, you can close MedTool. And if you reopen MedTool after some time, you see here, there's a folder which is called my project. you open it and you have exactly the same status and you can start running the script. Now, shortly also explain what this here means or this box is here. So what we can do, we can, with this button here, we run this one script. If you'd like to run this and this script, we simply click this button. So you see it's now running this script. It's running the second script, which is a nice tool if you modify anything.